Hey everyone. I decided to do something a little bit different. Rather than always just posting streams, there's a lot of questions that usually flow in either from the Gitter chat room for the material design project or even on these YouTube videos. One question that came in recently was about changing the material design theme at runtime, so specifically just bouncing back and forth and changing out the primary color. And I thought I had put together some samples for it, and currently the only samples I can find are actually inside of the demo app. Though they're fairly good, especially for people maybe a little unfamiliar with WPF or just getting started, this is actually a fairly common question that comes up quite a bit, so I thought I would go through and put together a short video along with some sample code. So, for those people who are unaware, I do have an examples project. The link will be in the description below, along with a link directly to this project inside of it, since there are quite a few projects. But let's dive in, and we will build out something quick and simple. So in my material design samples project, let's go down to theming, I think. And we'll just create a new project. So new project, let's see, something about WPF. WPF application sounds great. We're gonna call this change primary color, sure. And then we're gonna bury this underneath the theming folder. Just so that it stays there, that'll work. Let's see. Sure, we'll do .NET 6. Why not? Why not? This is also worth noting, the difference between long-term support and current. If you are able to, you probably want to be up on .NET 6. And you'll also note I am using Visual Studio 2022. I'm currently on the preview, but I believe the preview is pretty much in line with the current release. Okay, so first thing we're going to do is we're going to go through and add in the material design project, because that is what is needed. So let's go in here and we will browse and do material design. Just grab the latest release, which at present is 4.2.1. There's going to be a couple API changes between what I'm going to show here and what's likely to be in the next release, but I will leave some comments along those lines. Okay, so we'll start here with the application resources, and the first thing I want to pull up is if we go and look at the demo application. Boom. So inside of the project, look at the WPF demo, and then come down to app.xaml. You'll note it calls out several different ways of setting up the theme, and I think we're just going to start with this because this is by far the easiest. And you'll note, for people unfamiliar with WPF, there's this little material design colon thing in the beginning. That's actually coming from this guy right here. So we want to grab that first, which is the namespace include. We'll just include that there. And then we will grab this is the color theme here that we want. So I'm going to do resource dictionary, merge dictionaries, boom, and we'll put that guy in there. So this will get us set up with the primary color of deep purple and the secondary color of lime. This color adjustment, this is something optional. You can either choose to include or not. This will automatically try to adjust your foreground and background colors to achieve a good contrast ratio. But it does mean that the exact color that you set will not necessarily be the color used. So if you care more about setting colors and having it adhere exactly to what you set, just get rid of it. If you like just having it automatically adjust for a good contrast ratio for you, put it on. So there's kind of two different camps of what people like, and so pick whichever one makes most sense to you. And then the last one we need is we need the style themes, which is the default dictionary here. And that is enough to go ahead and get us up and rolling there. The next thing that we need to do is set up our main window. There's a bunch of properties you can go through and set on them, but the easiest thing to do is just set the style. There is a material design window style, and this will get you set up with all of the default colors and themes so that this appropriately interacts with it. The other thing I will call out here is this base theme is set to inherit. So what this will end up doing is picking either dark or light theme based upon the user's window settings. But if you would prefer to not have it be toggling between light and dark theme and you want to be in control of what that is, you can simply just change this to light or dark here as well. I like to do inherit just because it makes things nice and easy, but we will set that up. Okay, so let's actually figure out what we're going to do. So let's do something like maybe a group box with a header. Guy in. I don't know how well the designer is going to play with this. I see the designer have all kinds of problems at times, so I'm going to just build the project real quick to see. The new designer in Visual Studio 2022 is great. Still not perfect. There we go. We got a group box header, and you can see it's already populating the purple color. So how about change theme? Example, something like that maybe, and then down inside of here, actually, you know what, let's put the group box at the root. That sounds good. And then inside of here, I'm gonna do a grid, and how about a couple columns, because I'm thinking we're just gonna keep this really simple. We'll have two columns. They'll each take up 50% of the width. So by not specifying anything for the width property of a column definition, it's the equivalent of one star. Which is the equivalent of just star, which is the default, so we can omit it. We'll do that, and this will give each of them equal spacing for 50%. And then down here, we will do button content. Let's go with deep purple, something like that. Sure, that'll work. And then we will do one more button, and let's do, I don't know, green. And we'll come down here. And actually, let's do, nope. Stop helping me. Here, I don't know what I clicked. Stop, cancel. I don't know what I told you to do. Please stop what you're doing. Okay, so first of all, let's put the green one over in the second column. So we'll just bounce them over to that side. I'm gonna clean these guys up a little bit. Let's do a bit of a margin around here, maybe just 5 on each side. So margin of 5, just to give them a little space. Show some space around it. And then we're gonna actually make the background here be purple, because why not? How about light purple? Is there not a light purple? Medium purple. There, that's pretty good. Not quite the same as the theme color, but meh, good enough. And then this guy here, we will set his background to, how about light green? Something like that. Okay, these are just arbitrary colors I'm picking. Nothing fancy. And then I'm gonna leave the border around here being the theme color. So I intentionally did the group box at the top just so that there's a theme color to be seen, so we can see that go through and be done. Okay, next thing we gotta do is we need to set up some code to actually change the theme when the user clicks the buttons. So I very much like the MVVM style of coding inside of WPF. However, in the interest of keeping things simple, I'm gonna just do some straight click handlers. So for those people who are interested, I'll also link to my getting started with WPF video as well. If you wanna dive into that, just know that would usually be a view model, command handlers, etc. But for this, we're just gonna do this. So, and I'm gonna rename this purple click, then double click here. Gonna do here green click. Okay, so now we're gonna write a little method in here, private void set primary color. We'll just pass in a color, so we'll just do that. Okay, so this will do set primary color with color of, what did we say, medium purple. Sorry, colors, medium purple. Now, there's obviously ways you could go through and set this up to make it work with all kinds of interactions, such that the color passed here matches the background color specified on the button. For now, we're just hard coding stuff, because the point of this is to just be a nice simple example. Okay, so now setting the primary color. In the current version, the 4.2.1 release of material design, that's done with the palette helper. Palette helper. Cool. And we will do, I'm trying to remember, I think it's just straight new. I'm gonna double check that real quick. But I'm pretty sure this is the one that's going to go through and do it. Yep, this should get me what I want. Perfect. So you just do new palette helper. The comment here, this is the API in 4.2.1. Let's see. For release it for versions. After this point, use theme manager. And actually, I'm going to get the full API in here. So this is one of the APIs that's actually in the process of being updated. However, the methods on palette helper and the methods on theme manager are going to be almost identical. So just be aware of that, that if you're worried about how this is going to change, a lot of it is we're just getting rid of palette helper. The only APIs that are really changing are how you reference it and get a new instance. Palette helper, you just call new on it, which is kind of misleading. Theme manager's got some static methods on it that are a little more explicit. So get theme manager for application, get theme manager for resource dictionary, etc. Just so that it's a little bit more clear about what the source of those colors are. Because this is not very clear that this is coming from the application dictionary, because this palette helper is actually going to go up to your application, look into your resource dictionaries, and pull out what your theme is there. Okay, so down here, what we will do is palette helper, let's see, we need to get the current theme. So this will retrieve the current theme in an iTheme object. And I'm actually just gonna go var theme. With the theme manager, be aware this changes from an iTheme to just a theme class. Small but important difference. The theme class will also have a lot more brushes on it. But for what we're doing here, these APIs will be the same. And then we're just gonna do set primary color. And this will go here. Now, it's important to note that setting the primary color on the theme doesn't actually change your running application. This is just mutating that current theme object with the new color. In order to apply that, you then need to assign that theme back into your application. So just like how we retrieve the theme from the palette helper, so get current theme, go here, apply primary color, about apply theme to application, palette helper, set theme, theme, we're done. And that's all there is to it. And actually, we can go one step further. Let's test it. Get this guy fired up, compile and run, and see if it works. Okay, so we've got the change theme example. You'll note my background is dark. Only because my Windows theme is currently set to dark theme. So if we click green, goes there, purple goes there. And that's all it takes. So with a few lines of code, it's pretty easy, especially once you have your initial material design theme project set up, to go through and change out the theme. There's also a variety of things that you can go through if you really want to customize this theme out and manipulate a lot of the brushes. You can find them all located on the theme object or these helper methods. They're similar ones for setting the base theme for dark or light, as well as setting the secondary color as well, so rather than just the primary color. But hopefully this answers your question. If anyone else has questions that you would like to ask or post, feel free to leave them in the comments. I'm hoping to do a lot more of these kind of quick tutorial videos for common questions that come up. So with that, I will say happy coding. Good luck.